Hi, I'm Vicky Kaushal.
Hi, I'm Yami Gautam.
And you're watching us on
CineBlitz.
Hi guys, this is Karan Shah from CineBlitz and I have two star performers, Yami Gautam and Vicky Kaushal here. Their film Uri is coming out, so let's have a chat with them. You know, 2 years and 4 months since the deadly attack and the following surgical strike, you guys are coming with such a fantastic film. You know, you guys relived the story and the horror. What emotions were you feeling?
There were many details that when you come to know as a citizen of this country, it fills you with angst, it fills you with sadness, and then fills you with pride also eventually, fills you with gratitude, all of that. And we went through all those emotions through the film. In our efforts to replicate that story, in our efforts to portray those characters, knowing that our brave soldiers were martyred in their sleeps, unarmed, in the very beginning of dawn, you know, and it's very sad to know that such an incident had happened, and then when you get to know the story of how the surgical strike was planned, executed, conceived, and done in such a covert way, you feel proud of our forces, of our intelligence, of our administration to have conducted such an operation, to have given such an answer to terrorism. So just to be getting an opportunity to tell that story. Till yesterday, you know, yesterday we were in Lucknow and we got to meet the family members of some of the martyrs who lost their lives in the Uri attack. And it's an experience that, and I'm sure Yami felt the same way, that it was so different, it was so new that you just don't know what to say. You just don't know what to say. All we could do is just hold their hands and just bow down to them in gratitude. You don't know what to say. There's a little kid who was asked that, what do you want to become when you grow up, and he still said Fauji. You know, and it was just so hard-hitting in a very positive way.
True.
And we also met one of the survivors of the Uri attack who was there when the Uri attacks happened. He saw all of this happening and he shared his experience. And we're still living all of that, you know. It's not just while we were shooting, it's just every day we're getting something new to know, and it's an experience, it's a different experience.
You know, the Uri attack left a huge impact in India. Not only the ties were, you know, strained, even Bollywood had an impact. You know, Pakistani artists were banned and everything. What do you think about this whole situation between India and Pakistan?
It's volatile. It keeps fluctuating. This time when the Uri attacks had happened, you had said, like, you know, the artists were banned, and that was a sad thing that happened. But at the same time, you feel, you know, if that is a way, if you can give a silent protest to make them question their own government, to make them question their own administration as to what is happening from their end, why not, you know? But it's sad that artists have to face the brunt, but at the same time, nation comes first, the lives of our soldiers come first, and you have to see it from that point of view.
You know, you both play stern characters, very tough characters in the film. So what was the atmosphere on the set? What was the dynamics actually?
You know, somebody who would actually, what he said is actually totally correct, and I just like to make a small input here that, you know, it's often assumed that only if you've cracked jokes on a set or had a party, that's a fun set. I think when you work, you are happy coming to your set and excited to meet your team, work with your team, and collaborate and enjoy that process. That's fun. For me, that's fun. And somebody, if you technically want to get into some one-liners or sense of humor, that's Pareshji.
His humor is amazing.
Yeah.
His wit is amazing.
So exactly. So we would, even in the middle of something intense, where we are in the middle of, you know, some shots getting changed and it's another shot and we're waiting, which is, Pareshji would just crack up something. He doesn't mean to be funny also. It's not a joke that he would crack, but the way he would say things, you know how an andaaz apna apna? It was not on, it's just funny. It's just in the middle of something, you're reading something serious, suddenly Pareshji's voice or comment on something will just be like, so out.
You know, the star performer of 2017 with Kabil, the star performer of 2018 with Razi. Both of you have made some fantastic choices of films. How do you guys go about it? And do you consciously take up films or is it more subjective?
For me, the attempt has always been to keep exploring myself with every film. What more can I do? What more can I can add to the film in terms of as a performer? And to really, really good work with good filmmakers who can help you explore the best version of you as a performer in the most versatile ways as possible. That's it. That's what I feel.
Vicky?
Karan, when a film is offered, if I'm reading a script or when I'm hearing a narration, I try to, the first narration, I try to be an audience, not the actor. I see if the story is affecting me or not. That's the most crucial thing for me. Then if that step is taken, that the story is affecting me, I feel like talking about the story with people. I feel very excited that I got to hear something amazing today. That's the first thing that I really, really require. After that, yes, it's a director's medium. You look into who the director is, what his or her vision is, what role they're offering to you. If you've done anything of that sort in your career before that, or is it something that is scaring you? Is it something so fresh that you don't know if you'll be able to pull it off? All of those aspects come into play, but initially it's the story. If it's moving you, if it's affecting you, then that's the most important thing for me.